Welcome to DSTV Roundtable. I am Donovan Goliath, and today we are in the presence of greatness. Guys, I want to find out, because you're obviously all very busy people, you know, working on your respective shows and other ideas. What is the one show on DSTV that I think you binge, number one, that you just go, I wish I was involved in this, or I wish I had made this? I'll start with you, Roz.
So I have a very guilty pleasure. Real Housewives of Mzansi.
Yes.
Is that your vibe?
I tell you, yes, that show, I am the person on Twitter going, and this person didn't, and like, my whole opinion will be there. You can, if you search my Twitter you go hashtags Real Housewives of Mzansi, it's all there. Christelle.
Like, Christelle.
I love that show, and I can't wait for the new season. I hope it's going to come very soon. But I found it so entertaining. I couldn't watch it, I would watch it like, because I have kids, so I can't watch it now when it's on because kids. But I would like make a time for myself. Then if it was on a Friday night, it should be on a Friday night. Then on the Saturday afternoon, that would be like my treat for the week to now catch up. And sometimes I'd have even two episodes that I hadn't watched.
Look at you.
So that would be the ultimate. I just love it. Like the decadence and how they fight amongst each other and the skinnering. And
the shade.
And the shade in the diary cams. The shade in the diary cams are just
so
my best. Because I
often have that. Like for Sangomas.
You see.
Is there more than one Sangoma on your show?
Yes, there is.
Is there beef?
Yes.
But there is it.
I think we got it then.
To create it. There is. You know when the show, the idea came up 4 years ago, but it wasn't really for a Sangoma show.
Yeah.
The production company, Dimmy's my friend, the CEO of it. So we wanted like a show about club hosts because I used to organize events a lot. And then after a while, I just stopped because, you know, Ancestors didn't want that. The music was too loud. I didn't want to be around people, you know. I just preferred being on my own most of the time. So I then said to her, yo, let's have a Sangoma show. I see these shows on TV, but I will give you anything you want, you know, just put me on TV, I'll give you a show. And she ran with it. She did all the paperwork, she pushed it, and we're here today. She then said to me, get another Sangoma. Okay, I don't have friends much who are also in this healing business because, you know, people gossip, people talk a lot and things like that. So I choose to have friends outside what I do. And then I met this lady who's now part of the show because of me, might I add.
Ooh.
And she was very nice when she, you know, when I approached her. And yes, was. I approached her, I pitched the show, and I said, you know what, this is going to bring a lot of business, and we're going to teach people. People are going to understand what healing is about, and we're young. You're a nurse, you know, a professional nurse, and whatever, whatever. She liked the idea and then ran with it. Now she's part of the show. Now she's pompous. Now she said things behind my back. Really?
Ooh. Look, Ross, it's here.
I know I'm Patti LaBelle, right? But why would you say that? You know, like, I've been supporting you. I mean, she's gone through things and I've been there. And we will never be the same.
Yeah. I think you and I need to chat so I can maybe pitch the real Sangomas of Mzansi.
Yes.
Yeah. I can give you a list.
Okay, great.
You can check them out on the gram, man. You've got your Range Rover. Just sham.
Fantastic. Pierre, what's your guilty pleasure?
My favorite show that I saw on Showmax was, it's from overseas, Atlanta. It's one of the best shows ever, but locally, my guilty pleasure, and I'm a walking cliche because of this, because I'm an Afrikaner, is Come Braai With Me, because you see inside, I think as a writer, I'm a bit of a voyeur, so I sit in malls and I listen to people chatting, and I love, it's a bit creepy, but anyway, and Come Braai With Me for me is that, you go into people's houses, and also the shade being gooi there, when it's on, I can't stop watching. It's just
so weird.
And the disgusting dishes they make. I'm like, what is that? What are you doing? I like it.
That's so interesting. I did not see that one coming. That's amazing. How about you, Yanina?
I'm loving what Mnet's doing at the moment. I think the scripted content on Thursdays and the local content that they produce on Thursdays are absolutely fantastic. I am so consumed by Inconceivable, it's not even funny.
Right.
It's so good, it's so good. Mm. And the production house, they did such an amazing job.
Yeah.
I'm also a Legacy fan through and through.
Yeah.
I watch it every day from Monday to Thursday at 7, I watch it. I think that's nice and fresh, that I also love. And then something that consumed the country, and we've been promoting it on Talks and Chips for such a long time, and when it finally hit our screens, I was absolutely blown away by it. And I literally, Chasing the Sun has been one of the best sport dockies I've ever seen. And I love a sticky sport dockie, like I eat it for breakfast. And that has been close to perfect that I can see. And not only as a sport lover, and not only that I've been to the World Cup and I saw what was happening there, just the interviews with the players, just the coach getting real. And for us as sport lovers, thinking, Rassie, you are as mad as can be. What are you doing? Why are you picking these players? And a year after all the events, all the puzzle pieces just came together. And in the last episode, Rassie spoke so beautifully about Makazulu Mpimpi, and about, if you didn't see it, it was absolutely beautiful. It's running around on social media. And just that, the emotion within this coach and what he feels with his players, and just the method behind all of his madness for 4 years, and what it took for those players and those families and Rassie. I know he also went through difficult times, but to see that unfold in a 5-part series was just absolutely beautiful. The shots, the flashbacks, all of that we forgot about, how the All Blacks whitewashed us, and where people were burning jerseys and writing off the Springboks, and just that road, and how these producers knew to get in cameras at that World Cup, I still do not know. But hats off to them and to this fantastic venture between Mnet and Supersport. Chasing the Sun has been an absolute treat the past couple of weeks. And it's on catch up if you haven't seen
that. That show is definitely so passionate. It's like a public service, because a lot of emotionally closeted men I know just cry. Just watch the thing and cry.
Yes.
Like,
power of storytelling, eh? Like, you can't deny a good story. I always love when something like this comes along every once in a while. Yeah. You don't have to have a single interest in rugby.
Mm. Yes.
It's, for me, it's not even about rugby.
No.
It's about people.
Yes.
It's about courage. It's about determination. It's about hope, teamwork, all of these things coming together. And as a human being, you will always resonate with those kinds of things. It was such a wonderful balance. Do you know how many people suddenly found a new interest in rugby just after watching that? I always find that amazing, how you can convert a person who has just been adamant, this is not my thing.
But there are so many other sport documentaries or TV shows out there that do that. And I, as a sports lover, and it's my job, I've watched all of that. And just to get the behind the scenes thing, you get so intrigued, and I think this is what this platform is all about. Hearing about what we're talking, and you immediately, you're intrigued, and immediately you're a super fan. Same thing happened with me with Formula One. Never used to watch it, watch the show, and I'm a fanatic now. Like, it's a freak now. Like, I've got like jerseys and stuff, just like this, because of the power of a good TV show. Yeah. And that is exactly what you're trying to do, what we're all trying to do.
Passion.
Ne?
You want to go and catch up on all of this now? No, you were in. Kabosa, how about you?
Sure. I'm not that television literate, I must say. I always want to watch more narrative, but unfortunately my routine doesn't let me go and sit in front of the television. So I have to really binge over weekends or make time, you know. And this is not a guilty pleasure, but like beers, I mean, I'm very proud to say that I'm one of those typical watchers of the book club and Feinskrif and all
yes.
of that.
Yes.
Because it was such a relief that scripted content was suddenly so current and contemporary and, you know, sort of, in Afrikaans we'd say onvoorspelbare stereotypes.
Yeah.
They would break it down for you. But I like watching BBC and CNN very, very much, not because I have to, but also what I like is one would think it's political, and I'm not that political even. It's actually the broad church that they give you, you know, to see that things like art and guilty pleasures and all of that is also important. Just to add to Janina and Chasing the Sun, what I like now is that people are feeling such relief that something that is associated with something that we are so proud of has so many swear words that we are finally set
That's
loose,
so
you know.
Great.
Because everyone wants to be a fly on the wall in a change room.
Yeah.
And now for the first time, we were.
Yeah.
Yeah.
We were allowed to enter this space. We were allowed to see a video session or a training session, and actually the words that were spoken at halftime during the Rugby World Cup final, something we've all been craving for and wanted. He asked the guys, so what did Rossi say during halftime? Oh, you know, But this was the first time ever in my life that I could actually see and witness for myself, see what happened there. They had a lot of food in those change rooms, eh?
Do you know what is the great thing for me? Being able to, and Kabos and I were working on the same program, a breakfast TV show, being able to be part of a story as it develops. I was on air the morning after Madiba passed away. And just the sheer amount of work between when we got that call at about 11:15 and being on air at 5:30. We had guests, we had people that were close to him. We were able to be part of the story as it, and it was just, it's something that I will never forget. And it's because of DSTV that I had that opportunity, that we had that opportunity, because we were on a platform that gave us the chance to be part of it. As sad as it was, we were also celebrating the life of this legendary man, you know?
Absolutely.
Yeah, and you do the fire drill, but you never
yes,
know.
Yes, like how many times we practiced
I know, and there's nothing like the perfect storm. I
no.
mean, the morning of Oscar Pistorius, that was just, you couldn't believe. A journalist told me, she said, South Africa is so wonderfully weird and absurd, and you often think, can next year be more absurd? Can something happen that can be more absurd, and then something happens?
Yes.
You know? Yeah.
Crazy times. Thank you. Thank you so much for sharing. There we go. Now you guys know what your favorite stars like to binge. This is like, I'm keen now to come and just to go and check out all of these things that you guys have been talking about. I'm really like, and I'm waiting for this one. You guys need to make, that's the one that I'm absolutely waiting for.
Wow. No, I'm not in Mzansi. The real Sangomas of Sandton.
Oh. No, I'm in Mondio. I'm in the south of Joburg.
Of Mondio. Okay, well.
But I'll makes give it you even posh if you want posh.
We'll find a place. We'll find
what
a place.
What must I do?
Oh. You want posh, I'll give you posh.
Thank you guys for tuning in to DSTV Roundtable, another fantastic episode. Please do remember to like, comment, and subscribe so you never miss an episode. And also let us know who else you would like to see on these seats. Thank you guys once again for coming through and hanging out and sharing all of your stories. You can catch their shows on DSTV and of course on the DSTV app. The link is in the description below. Take care. Bye.